So in one dimension, of course, in one dimension, the equation just reduces to so in one dimension, we can imagine we have a one-dimensional core, some initial pressure, P initial, we assume that one boundary has a fixed pressure, we'll call P1, the other boundary has a fixed pressure, we'll call P2, and so the boundary conditions then for this example would be that P at x and all times 0, I'm sorry, P at x and time 0 is equal to P initial. And we'll go ahead and give that a value because we're going to try to solve this in closed form. So we'll just say that that's equal to 0. So there's initially no pressure, no initial pressure. And then we'll assume that P at 0 for all time is equal to P1. And we'll assume that that's 1,000 psi for our model problem, for our example. And P at L for all time is equal to P2, and that's equal to 0. And so it turns out Mathematica actually has the ability to solve this equation. Mathematica actually has the ability to solve this equation, so let's see if we can do it. We're going to define the equation as dP of x and time, one derivative with respect to time. It's equal to 1 over alpha dp of x and t with two derivatives with respect to x. So that's our equation. And what we're going to say then is d solve equation. And then we have to give the boundary conditions. Right? So for all x and time t equals to 0, we have p init. For x equal to 0 and all time, we have p1. And for x equal to l and all time, we have p2. We're going to solve this for p at x and t, where x and t are the variables. Okay, so there's the solution. It's kind of ugly. You can see that it's actually an infinite series here. And so we'll go ahead and plot this to see what it looks like, but we of course won't be able to use the infinite series, so we'll just take a few terms, maybe the first 10 or 20 terms, should give us a pretty good picture of what the solution looks like without wasting. You know, of course, if you really want an accurate term, you would take maybe a few thousand terms. We'll just take the first 10 terms. And we have to plug in some numbers, right? So we said that P1 is equal to 1,000. P2 will be equal to 0. P init was equal to 0. We have to give it a length, we'll just use 1, and we also have to define alpha. Again, we'll just use 1, just for demonstration purposes. So there's the first 10 terms, and now this would be something that we could plot. For a given time, so let's give it a time, say 0.01 seconds. So we can plot that as a function of x that goes from 0 to 1. And so there we have it. We should probably fix the plot range to be. From in the x direction, we want to go from 0 to 1, and in the y direction, we need to go from 0 to 1,000. Okay, so that's at one time. What we could do next is, instead of plotting it for a fixed time, we could plot a series of these. For times that say go from 0.01 to 0.5 in steps of 0.01. And then we should be able to animate this. So that should give a picture of how the pressure distribution in the core evolves over time. Right? So initially, very small times, there's kind of a high gradient that goes from 1,000 to 0. But eventually, the pressure will equilibrate, and so that you have a linear distribution between 1,000 and 0 across the core. So again, what you're seeing here is a progression in time. So as time progresses with these parameters, it comes into equilibrium.